Let's head back to Exmouth now, where our cosmic correspondent is standing by ahead of the news at 6 o'clock. Tomo, you've been to see one of the best places to view tomorrow's eclipse.
Michael, we have. It's 30 kilometres out of town. It's the official viewing site. There's going to be up to 3,000 people will be there. And it is absolutely huge. It's been converted over the past 8 to 9 weeks. It's an extraordinary sight. We also were there when the official scientists arrived. They'll be put in what will be an official area. They'll be viewing it. What they'll also be doing is live streaming it to the world. This will be seen not just here in Western Australia, around Australia, but right around the world. The event is that big. And Michael, I have to say, the atmosphere is just fantastic. Everyone's in a great mood. Everyone's ready to see something very special.
And there are some other big characters in town too. Some people travelling from all over just to be there tomorrow.
Yeah, part of our story tonight, a part of three stories tonight coming from Exmouth, just some of the people who've travelled. One, his name is Bam Bam, although his Australian friends call him Bammo. He's been to 20 different eclipses. There's some have seen 16, 11, 10. Mongolia, the Americas, Asia to Antarctica. So these are experienced watchers, and they have something otherworldly about them. They're really nice people. They're very interesting people. Hear their story, plus much more from Exmouth at 6.
Bam Bam, looking forward to it. Michael Thompson, thank you.
WA has put on some big shows, but never with a stage as big as this one.
It's this amazing, dare I say, universal thing. It just, people are interested in the stars and the universe, and this spectacular event of the moon moving in front of the sun to cause an eclipse just really stirs something in the human psyche, and people want to be a part of it.
And nothing has been left to chance. Scientists from all over the world arriving in town and then immediately setting up their equipment at the official viewing site 30 kilometres from Exmouth. From here, they'll live stream the eclipse around the globe and capture those 62 seconds of darkness, or as they call it, totality.
Millions of people get to see this because it's a very small part of the world that's going to get to see this eclipse, and we want to share it with everyone around the world.
It is quite an amazing thing to see. People get emotional. All sorts of emotions happen when the sun goes into totality. So, yeah, it's a fantastic thing to have.
While they may not be scientists, they are every bit as enthusiastic, and between them, these international eclipse chasers have extraordinary experience.
Where are you guys from?
I'm from Nimbin, Australia, but I live in Bali.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
And from the US.
Yes.
Yeah, 42-hour flight to Perth, and then drove up from there.
That's a long way to come.
It is.
How many eclipses have you seen?
I'm not certain, but around 20.
Around 20?
Yeah.
Bam Bam from New York, or Bammo, as his Aussie friends call him, will watch his 20th eclipse.
So it's the three most significant planetary bodies for our existence going into perfect alignment, like three notes on a guitar. The sun, which provides us all of our life energy, the earth, which nurtures us, and the moon that keeps us in rhythm, all lining up. It's more powerful than anything you can ever experience.
Way to go, Bammo. Like he said, well, eclipse energy, it is here, and it's very big, spreading fast through Exmouth tonight. Tracy Vo, the Shire is keen to keep eclipse hunters moving, making transport smooth in and out of town.
Well, the shuttle buses are in place, Michael, and from what we've seen today, tourists are really making the most of them. Those road closures as well in the town centre, they have been eased following those frustrations voiced by locals who say businesses have been impacted. But the town is really turning it on for those visiting Exmouth and those who live here, early this morning putting on a nature show.
Attracting a crowd for a very different reason. Town beach entertaining the out-of-towners. Witnessing a homecoming for 40-year-old Chomper, rehabilitated and back in the water. The shoreline to be packed come tomorrow morning. Solar fever is spreading through the region.
A total eclipse of the heart.
These chasers totally eclipsed by Exmouth.
Usually to get a really rare, hard to get to eclipse, you're standing in the middle of the desert. Here you can get a coffee at the lovely little coffee shop and chat with people.
Since Sunday, 2,463 cars have rolled into town. Checking in at the overflow camp today, 430 groups. Ensuring a smooth operation, Exmouth's Eclipse Coordination Unit. More than 100 extra personnel bolstering emergency crews.
We can monitor the number of people coming into the town and moving around the town.
In the town centre, restrictions have been eased, with road closures now on a smaller scale.
Around Federation Park, there was a little bit of constraints around people accessing the shops through some of the car parks there. We've moved some of the traffic management facilities.
Getting in and out made easier with these shuttle buses, tourists making the most of the free service. Four in operation, they're on a constant loop, ferrying passengers of all kinds every 10 minutes.
Basically, it's just one big loop and it's great. You know, they're trying to encourage people to not drive around. They're trying to encourage people to get on these things and get off these things.
Taking advantage, Sydneysiders Keith and Gail Seely, who are staying at the Welch Street campground.
Yeah, it's been organised very well. They're on bikes, showing people where to camp, and yeah, they've been cleaning the toilets regularly. You see,
All the amenities are fine. Yeah.
Perth student Ben Young has his own set of wheels. His pushy getting him from Esperance to Exmouth, the mammoth journey, the first leg of his worldwide ride.
So I've never seen a total eclipse before, so I'm pretty excited to see it, and as much as everyone else is up here.
Getting here whichever way they can, with one more sleep to go. In Exmouth, Tracy Vaux, Nine News.
Well, Eclipse Energy, it is here and it's very big, spreading fast through Exmouth tonight. Tracy Vaux, the Shire is keen to keep eclipse hunters moving, making transport smooth in and out of town.
Well, the shuttle buses are in place, Michael, and from what we've seen today, tourists are really making the most of them. Those road closures as well in the town centre, they have been eased following those frustrations voiced by locals who say businesses have been impacted. But the town is really turning it on for those visiting Exmouth and those who live here. Early this morning, putting on a nature show. Attracting a crowd for a very different reason. Town Beach entertaining the out-of-towners. Witnessing a homecoming for 40-year-old Chomper, rehabilitated and back in the water. The shoreline to be packed come tomorrow morning. Solar fever is spreading through the region.
A total eclipse of the heart.
These chasers totally eclipsed by Exmouth.
Usually to get a really rare, hard to get to eclipse, you're standing in the middle of the desert. Here you can get a coffee at the lovely little coffee shop and chat with people.
Since Sunday, 2,463 cars have rolled into town. Checking in at the overflow camp today, 430 groups. Ensuring a smooth operation, Exmouth's Eclipse Coordination Unit. More than 100 extra personnel bolstering emergency crews.
We can monitor the number of people coming into the town and moving around the town.
In the town centre, restrictions have been eased, with road closures now on a smaller scale.
Around Federation Park, there was a little bit of constraints around people accessing the shops through some of the car parks there. We've moved some of the traffic management facilities.
Getting in and out made easier with these shuttle buses, tourists making the most of the free service. Four in operation, they're on a constant loop, ferrying passengers of all kinds every 10 minutes.
Basically, it's just one big loop and it's great. You know, they're trying to encourage people to not drive around. They're trying to encourage people to get on these things and get off these things.
Taking advantage, Sydneysiders Keith and Gail Seely, who are staying at the Welch Street campground.
Yeah, it's been organised very well. On bikes, showing people where to camp, and yeah, they've been cleaning the toilets regularly. You see,
All the amenities are fine. Yeah.
Perth student Ben Young has his own set of wheels. His pushy getting him from Esperance to Exmouth, the mammoth journey, the first leg of his worldwide ride.
So I've never seen a total eclipse before, so I'm pretty excited to see it, and as much as everyone else is up here.
Getting here whichever way they can, with one more sleep to go. In Exmouth, Tracy Vaux, Nine News.